Water is essential for our gardens to thrive and produce healthy food for our families. But many of us are experiencing the worst droughts in our living memory. Even in balmy temperate climates, we can now get heat waves and weeks without rain. Standard solutions help, like spreading mulch, growing drought-tolerant plants, and using recycled water. But there is a remarkably straightforward solution that we tend to overlook: getting more water infiltrating and stored in our soil. How do we do this? Simply by growing more vegetation. Trees and shrubs provide shade and wind protection, reducing water loss from evaporation. But do you know the indispensable role vegetation plays? Plants are the main food source for the soil organisms maintaining our soil infrastructure. Soil organisms get their food supplies from root tissues, root exudates, and organic waste materials deposited on the soil, which are mainly leaves and other plant tissues, animal remains, and manure. When provided with a decent diet, soil organisms construct crumbly soil with water-holding particles with spaces in between for water storage. They also consume the leaves and other organic waste materials, turning them into organic matter, which acts like a sponge, storing water up to 90% of its weight. Spreading mulch and compost isn't as effective as growing living plants, as only a small portion of the organic materials from above ground are retained long-term as organic matter. Organic materials from root and root exudates are needed to increase the levels of organic matter stored in our soil. Giving our soil organisms the resources to maintain the soil infrastructure, we drought-proof our gardens, reducing our water bills and extending our growing season into the dry. We benefit from 3 billion years of research and development carried out in every soil type on the planet, courtesy of nature.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video and found the information helpful, be sure to check out the resources on our website. See the links below. Together, we can reduce the costs of growing food for us and our environment.